Let us consider integrals where the integrand has distinct linear factors in the denominator. In this case, the best strategy to evaluate the integral is using this cover-up technique. You might be familiar with this technique already. So let us first consider the case wherein the integrand is a proper rational function. So when we say proper, in this case, the degree of the numerator is less than the degree of the denominator. So for example, we're evaluating this integral. This is a proper rational function because the degree of the numerator is 2, the degree of the denominator is 3, and we have here distinct linear factors. We have x, x minus 1, and then x plus 1. And we know that the partial fraction decomposition of this rational function is given by a over x plus b over x minus 1 plus c over x plus 1, where a, b, and c are real constants. So to find this a, b, and c, we use what we call cover-up technique. So here, if you want to find, let's say, the a, so just cover this x in the integrand. So it's like you have this expression without the x in the denominator, and evaluate it at the value of x that will make this x equal to 0. In this case, it is only x equal to 0. So when we plug in x equals 0 in this expression, we'll get negative 2 over negative 1 times 1. So that is negative 1, negative 2 over negative 1. It is equal to positive 2. So therefore, this is equal to 2 over x. Now, to find this constant b, again, we cover this x minus 1 in this integrand. So it's like you have this expression and you evaluate it at the x that will make this linear factor equal to 0. So that is x equal to 1. So when we plug in x equals 1 to this expression, we'll get 1 squared minus 2 minus 2. So that is negative 3 over 1 times 2. So that is over 2. So therefore, b is negative 3/2. And our c, to find this constant c, we cover this x plus 1 in this integrand. So we'll get this expression and evaluate it at the x that will make this x plus 1 equal to 0, which is x equal to negative 1. So we'll get here 1 plus 2 minus 2, you'll get 1, all over negative 1 times negative 2. So that is positive 2. So therefore, c is equal to 1/2. And we'll get this expression. And this can be easily integrated. So the integral will be 2 ln of absolute value of x minus 3/2 ln of absolute value of x minus 1 plus 1/2 ln of absolute value of x plus 1 plus c. And using a property of ln, you may write this expression as in terms of a single ln. So you have here 1/2 ln of absolute value of x raised to 4 times the quantity x plus 1 all over x minus 1 quantity cube plus c. And you may actually put the constant c inside because a real number can be written as ln of another real number. Next integral. So pause this video if you want to try this out first. So we want here to integrate this x squared minus 3x plus 1 all over 2x times the quantity 3x minus 1 times the quantity x plus 2. So we have here again distinct linear factors, 2x and then 3x minus 1 and then x plus 2. So we can use the cover-up technique. So, of course, the partial fraction decomposition of this one, this is a proper rational function. We can write it as a constant over 2x plus another constant over 3x minus 1 plus a constant c over x plus 2. And to find this a, b, c using cover-up technique, so if you want to find this a in the numerator of this fraction with denominator 2x, so we cover this 2x in our integrand, so we'll get this expression and we plug in the x value that will make it 0, so that is x equals 0, and we'll get here 1 over negative 1 times 2, so that is negative 1/2. And then to find this constant b, we cover this 3x minus 1 in the integrand, we'll get this expression, And we evaluate it at the x value that will make this 0, which is equal to 1/3. So by plugging in this x equals 1/3, we'll get 1 over 9 minus 1 plus 1. And then this is 2 over 3. And then times 1/3 plus 2, so that is 7 over 3. So this is equal to just 1 over 9 over 14 over 9, which is equal to 1 over 14. And then for this c here, to find this c using cover-up techniques, so we cover the x plus 2 in our integrand, we'll get here this expression, and we plug in the x value that will make this 0, so that is x equals negative 2, we'll get 4 plus 6 plus 1 all over 2 times negative 2, so that is negative 4 times negative 7, we'll get 11 over 28. So now, if we'll get this ABC here, we can easily find the integral of this. Okay, so here it is just equal to negative 1/4 ln of absolute value of x. And to integrate this one, you use substitution. If this is your u, okay, your u is equal to 3x minus 1, your du will be 3 times dx. So its integral will be 1 over 42 ln, that is 1 over 14 times 1/3 ln of u. Your u is equal to 3x minus 1. And then plus 11 over 28 ln of absolute value of x plus 2 plus c. Now, what if the integrand is an improper rational function? When we say improper rational function, it's a rational function wherein the numerator has a degree that is equal or greater than the degree of the denominator. So, for example, this rational function. So the degree of the numerator is 4, degree of the denominator is 3. So this is an improper rational function. And in this case, you cannot use immediately partial fraction decomposition because you can only use that one for proper rational function. Only for rational functions wherein the degree of the numerator is less than the degree of the denominator. So the strategy for improper rational function is to perform first long division before using cover-up technique. So in this case, this is long division. We divide this numerator by this divisor or denominator and we'll get here 3x raised to 4 divided by x cubed, we'll get a 3x. And we multiply the entire divisor by a 3x, you'll get 3x raised to 4 minus 3x squared. So here I aligned like terms. And then we subtract the entire product from the dividend to obtain a new dividend. And we'll get here x cubed plus x squared minus 3x minus 2. And then we perform the same process. So we divide the leading term by this leading term of the divisor. We'll get 1. Multiply the entire divisor by 1. You'll get x cubed minus x. And then subtract this product from this new dividend. And you'll get here x squared minus 2x minus 2. And we stop here because the degree of this is less than the degree of the divisor. So therefore, this fraction can be written as the quotient 3x plus 1 plus this remainder, x squared minus 2x minus 2, all over the divisor, which is equal to x cubed minus x. And we can easily integrate this one, which is equal to 3 halves x squared, plus integral of 1 is just x. And the integral of this, okay, we found the integral of this a while ago. Okay, so this is just 1 half ln of absolute value, x raised to 4 times the quantity x plus 1 all over the cube of x minus 1, and then plus the arbitrary constant c. Okay, that's it for this lesson. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.